Hi, this is Ethan from Dark Zebra, and I just wanted to let you know that I'm in the process of writing a book for MongoDB. It's going to be a very small, simple book, and it's still in progress. But if you want to check it out, it's at github.com/darkzebra/mongodb-book, and you can give me some feedback and do some proofreading. That would be great. And everything that I cover in these videos will eventually be in this book. With that said, today we're going to be covering evaluation operators, which includes regex, where, text, and mod. We're also going to talk about querying subdocuments and how to find documents that have missing properties or null properties. We will start with the mod operator. And if you know mathematics, and if you've worked in programming at all, you know that mod stands for modulus, which is the remainder of a division operation. And it's really convenient for finding things that are odds, evens, highlighting every third row, that kind of thing. MongoDB has an ability to find, well, for instance, we want to find every book, let's say, that was written on an even year. And so what we're going to do here is go to find, and we're going to say, first of all, that it's our year of the book that we're searching under, and we have to pass in this subquery document. And in here we just do $mod, and this is an array. The first value is what we are dividing by. In our case, because we're looking for books written on an even year, we're going to divide by 2. And the second parameter is what the mod has to match. In other words, even years will have a modulus of 0. Odd years will have a modulus of 1. And so we're saying 2, take the year, divide mod 2, and anything that has a 0 is going to be an even year. And we want to find those records. So we hit enter. And you'll see here, I have 1936, 1952, 1940, 1868. So all of my even years, books written on even years, are showing up in this query. Right now, that's perhaps not very useful, but when you're working and when you need to get certain data, you're going to find that it is going to be useful for you later on. The second query or evaluation operator that we want to use is the regex, and we've already done some regular expressions. So I can just type in title and do something like war/i, and that is going to give me anything that has the title war in its name. But I can write this another way, which is to say I can pass in this subquery and do a regex, a $regex. And then in here, I can pass in /war/i, and it will give me the exact same results. The main difference for this is if you want to do more complicated ands or ors inside of something. But remember, there's something important on this, that you can't use this regex inside of an in, and that's a $in. So that we already covered regular expressions a little bit, but gives you an idea of how that works. Now we get to some more interesting, these last two pieces here. One is the text operator. And the text operator actually just goes on text indexes in your collection. What that means is that you don't actually have to pass in a field. You just go, it just looks for every index in your collection that is a text index. And so instead of passing in a field here, I just pass in text. And then my subquery document is going to have something like a $search and then some text, war. Now, oh, that was an error that I was expecting, but not the error I was expecting. This is the one I was expecting. I did db.books.find. I did a text search, but you'll notice the error I get is that I need to have exactly one text index for a text query. So this will only search if you have text indexes. And we'll cover indexes more later in another video. But for now, we can say db.books, and then we're going to say ensure index, the field we want to index on, and then the type of index we need. So in this case, title, and it's an index type of text. And now it's created that index. If we rerun our query now, we will get results. And it searches for title because that now has a text index. Important thing to remember here is that this will search anything that has a text index. So if I search if I create a bunch of indexes, it will search through all of them. The last evaluation operator we want to talk about is the where clause. And that is also a top level parameter. So I just have an object here with a dollar sign where. And it gives you a lot more power in finding records, but it will, MongoDB in a where will go through every record in your collection and test them against the evaluation parameters that you pass in. So it is a lot slower and a lot less efficient. So be very wise and very careful when you use this. The where can take two different things. One is a string, that is our evaluation operation, or we can actually pass in a function for more complicated things. So the where exposes this as the currently selected document. And because we're in books, we can say this.title, and we just want to find any book that has a long title length. So we're going to say greater than 25 characters. That string will get evaluated, and every record that matches will return true, and it will be returned in our record set here. We have two. The second way we can do this is via the function. And the function is very similar, but you can do a lot more things inside of there, obviously. The function just has to return a true or a false. And it also has the same things, it has like a this, and I can say title.length is greater than 25, and I have to return this. And once again, I get the same records. But you can see here, I can make more complicated queries and rules inside of this. So, there we are with our evaluation operators. The second to last thing that I want to talk about is finding null records. If you look deeper into our book collection, you'll notice that there's a couple books which don't actually have years associated with them. So if I do a search for years, they are never going to show up. And so what we want to do is find any book that doesn't have a year associated with it. And the way we can do this is just type in year equals null, and we'll find those two books, Iliad and The Art of War. Now, there's a small problem here, which is this actually, a null will work if, first of all, the property doesn't exist in the document, but it will also work if the document has explicitly set the year to be null. So what happens if I want to find explicitly ones that the property does not exist inside of the document? What I can do then is type in the same, very similar thing, except for now I have a subquery document, and I pass in exists, dollar sign exists, and set that equal to false. And this will find any record where it does not have that property. And once again, we find them. The difference is this will not find anything that has a null value in your searching field. So just keep in mind, you can search by null, but you could possibly get erroneous records. Exist will only find records that actually have that property existing. Finally, just a quick thing on subdocuments. As you'll notice in many of our books, our author is a subdocument. So it is a document that has a first name and a last name. So if I want to search by author, it doesn't work. because it is another document. So, well, and it helps to type in the correct method name. Nothing's there. But that's just because it's a subdocument. And the way you can search for subdocuments is you've got to make sure that your key is a string because you're about to use a period in there. But you can type in author.firstname and you can type in Brandon. And voila, now we found that book. We could also say John. And this is the way that we can search our subdocuments and find records that match within our subdocuments. So thanks for your time today. Feel free to subscribe and rate this video and give us any feedback or comments. Appreciate your time. Have a good day.
Thanks for watching this Dark Zebra presentation. Please rate this video and add it to your favorites if you liked it. For additional content, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel or visit us at darkzebra.com.